Welcome to Strength of Materials. In this video, let us see the numericals on the thick cylinders as we have seen in the previous video. So in this video, the first numerical is the thick cylinder's shell has a 1 meter dia and 200 mm thick is subjected to an internal pressure and 10 megapascal MPa and external fluid pressure of 2.5 megapascal MPa. Find the maximum and minimum intensity of circumferential stress and show the variation of circumferential and radial stresses across the thickness of the cylinder. So let us go to the solution. The thick diameter is 1 meter, 1000 mm, thickness T 200 mm. Radius 1 R1 will become as the 1000 divided by 2, which is equals to the particular 500 mm. Then radius R2 as 500 mm plus 200 mm, which is 700 mm as the external radius. Internal pressure P1 is equals to 10 MPa, 10 Newton per mm square. Then external pressure is 2.5 Newton per mm square. Moving further, now applying the boundary conditions to the above equations. So above equations are for the things such as b by x square minus a. So at x as r1 means radius number 1, which is internal radius 500 mm, internal pressure px is 10 Newton per mm square. And second condition, at x equals to r2, external radius 700 mm. So external pressure px 2.5 Newton per mm square. Substituting these boundary conditions in a radial pressure px, we get 10 is equals to b by 500 square minus a. So substituting that and finally writing it in terms of one equation 1. 2.5 b by 700 square minus a, b by that substitution and writing it as equation number 2. Subtracting equation 2 from equation 1, we get 7.5 is equals to b by 250,000 minus b by 490,000. Then the LCM part we are doing, then re-simplifying, and finally we get the value of b as 38,28,125, that is 3828125. Further, substituting the equation of value of b in the equation 2, we get value of a as 5.312. With the help of the values of a and b are substituted in the hoop stress. Now the hoop stress at any x distance or any x radius is found by the equation sigma x is equals to b by x square plus a. Substituting the value in this when x is at 500 mm and x is at 700 mm. So substitutions when we are doing in this, that time we get the sigma 500 value as 20.64 and x at 700 mm we get the value as 13.124 Newton per mm square. So values of a and b are again substituted in the circumferential stress. Now that is px is equals to b by x square minus a. When this value comes in terms of minus, so at x as 500 mm, p1 value is 10 Newton per mm square, and at x as 700 mm, p2 value is 2.5 Newton per mm square. These are the values of sigma x and px. Then writing the variation of that in terms of figure. So value of px is already known to us, 10 Newton and 2.5. So that if we are drawing it, internal diameter 500 mm, external diameter 700 mm and middle span of the two thickness it is 100 mm. So that is 600 mm if we take. So 600 mm substitutions when we do, we get this value as 5.32 Newton per mm square. Here we can see 10 Newton per mm square at internal surface, 2.5 Newton per mm square at the external surface. And this will be parabolic compression. This will be in terms of parabolic compression. So at 600 it is 35.321 Newton per mm square. Then variation of sigma x. Sigma x at internal diameter of 500 mm and external diameter of 500 mm and middle diameter of 600 mm. So we can see 20.625 Newton per mm square at internal face and 13.25 Newton per mm square at external face. That way it is again parabolic tension, and we are able to get the value of 600. Substituting 600 in terms of the equation, we get the value as 15.94 Newton per mm square. So these two figures, we need to draw it after the particular thing of calculation, otherwise it is not validating. So we need to make concentration that after we find out px value and sigma x value, we are going to plot it or show it the sketch. Moving with the another problem, a thick cylindrical shell of external diameter 300 mm and internal diameter 200 mm is subjected to internal pressure of 20 Newton per mm square and external pressure of 5 Newton per mm square. Determine the maximum hoop stress developed in the cylinder. Also draw the variation of hoop stress and radial stress, indicating the values at 25 mm intervals. So we need to determine the variations at every 25 mm intervals, otherwise we have to find it out. So every 25 mm intervals, how much will be the radius? Let us see. So solution part, internal diameter 200 mm, so internal radius is 200 divided by 200 mm. External diameter is 300 mm, external radius will be 300 divided by 150 mm. Internal pressure P1 as 20 Newton per mm square and external pressure P2 as 5 Newton per mm square. So that we were substituting in the further part with the above boundary conditions. At X as R1 100 mm, the internal pressure Px will be 20 Newton per mm square. At X R2 is equals to 150 mm, external pressure is equals to Px as 5 Newton per mm square. Substituting these boundary condition in radial pressure Px, we get 20 is equals to B by 100 square minus A. So simplifying that, equation number 1, and 5 is equals to B by 150 square minus A. So simplifying that, we are able to get this particular value. Then subtracting equation number 2 from equation number 1 mean this part. So 20 minus 15, 5 is 15. So 15 is equals to this particular simplification minus LCM, and this B value will be getting as 270,000, which will able to the value of B. B value as 270,000. Moving further for the particular calculation, let us see. Substitution this value in the equation 2, we get phi is equals to 270,000 divided by 225,000 minus A. So A value comes as 7. So these values of A and B are substituted in the hoop stress. Then we are calculating the value of sigma x. So as we have, they are mentioning us to calculate for the 25 mm variations, means simple variations 100, 125 and 150. Though we have calculated here for 100 for every 10 variations. So 5 iterations we have easily made here. So at x is equals to 100, what is the value sigma 100 as 34, and at x is equals to 110, value is 129.314. Then at x as 120, so sigma 120 will be 25. Similarly till x as 150 we have done, and we are able to see that the value as 19 Newton per mm square. So these are all the values of 10 mm differences. Then once we go for the further hoop stress, which is here, so at 125 mm, what is the value? So here when we see the value of 125 mm, so hoop stress, which is plus 7, we get it as 24.8 Newton per mm square. And when it is circumferential stress, minusing 7, that is value of A, so we get it as 10.28 Newton per mm square. When we go for the iteration that we are going to plot it, we are able to see that 100 and 150 mm are the two radiuses. 100 is internal, 150 is external, 125 is at the middle section of the thickness. So there we are able to see that it is 10.28 value what we are able to find it. Then going further, for the variation of that px, it is 100 mm is the internal radius, 150 mm is the external radius, then 125 is the middle radius, where we are able to see that the value is 24.28 newton per mm square, which is for the value of radius 125 as the x value. Thank you and see you in the next video.